I'd just like to say what a great honour it is to be invited here by Ann and Charlie, who we met for the first time, to our great delight, very recently. And they've invited me here to showcase an early medieval instrument that we reproduced, this particular one. It's the first accurate reproduction of an instrument that was recovered from a bog in Bacon in County Mayo, which is just very close by Knock, in 1794. And the original instrument now reclines in the keeping of the National Museum of Ireland. And it's made of yew wood, hand carved, and it's got a spiral of bronze ribbon decorating it. And it took us 2 years to find a piece of yew suitable to be able to make a new one. Luckily for us, the Office of Public Works were cutting down a branch of one of the beautiful old yew trees at Cong Abbey. So we were able to source that bit of wood. So this the original instrument is carbon dated at approximately 700 AD, which puts it very nicely in the early medieval period. Now, we don't have anything written, unfortunately, for this instrument. We don't know what it was originally called. The original one is entirely unique in the world, in that it's a horn, essentially, but it's played using a beating reed, in this instance, a bassoon reed. So what I would do is I would play just a very simple impromptu notes, a few notes strung together, just to show you what it sounds like. And maybe give you an idea of how it might have been used in the early medieval period. Here we go. I'd like to dedicate this impromptu few notes to Ann and Charlie here. And again, what a great honour it is to be invited.
I'm Guth, am talent to repen, am foam mara, am dove shek mren, am shay nai, am der grena, am Am torg er gael, am o i'n lŷn, am lach yn mai, am briond y, am brig donna,
usually starting out programs with this next set of pieces, and they are really contemporary with the time period of this harp, known as the Trinity College Harp or Brian Boru's harp, and they're from Trinity College manuscript. They're pieces that I chose from a large body of work from the service of St. Bridget, and I would call them the harp's interpretation of them, because I can't make this instrument do what it doesn't want to do. So, or at least it was a joint effort. And it's a little far now from St. Bridget's day, but this would be the period when an Irish harp was made at Candlemas. It would be turned over to a harper for the ceremony of the raising, and from the period of time from Michaelmas to Candlemas, 4 months essentially during the wet part of the year, this raising took place, and I believe it's the pulling up of the soundboard, the belly of the instrument. And then it was ready to play on Candlemas, which is St. Bridget's Day. And it's rather interesting to me that on that day, traditionally, beekeepers would light candles around the beehives to let the bees know it was spring and get ready to be busy. And so I like how all of these things coincide.
Thank you.
It's really refreshing to have musicians tuning when they actually really need to tune. Cormac McDermott was an Irish harper from Roscommon who ended up in England playing at the English court. And these are pieces that were preserved in a collection of in a publication out of Germany. I think there's about 8 or 9 of his pieces surviving. And they survive in parts, say for a treble instrument and a tenor and a bass line, things like that. And I thought, I wonder if he would have played these solo as well. So I came up with a solo version, and if Charlie's in tune, he might join me. We just celebrated our 36th wedding anniversary, so you can imagine how much direction. Actually, I don't know that we celebrated that much, but. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, here we go. Thank you. Is it Robert Tyler? Thank you.
Thank you.
never done this lit candle thing before, but and we've never done this piece except at the very end of a set, but this is a favorite prop, a candlestick, and I mentioned it was, it's maybe our most useful wedding gift. It's really done a lot of traveling now. And this goes back to bees, and we like to think that this rosk from the Kamoi Chera contains elements from a bee charm, and it's because of certain references that are could be translated as being meaningful to the practice of getting swarming bees to settle, things like branch for repose. And even up into the 20th century, traditional beekeepers, when bees were swarming, would tang on brass. That's banging on brass. Probably not this nice little, you know, it's probably more like the brass pans going together. But I'm banging on brass. Well, in this case, I'm banging on gold. But a lot of the clarifics traditionally are strung in, or were strung in brass. But that would... that was to get swarming bees to settle, and you'd want them on your land so you'd own the rights to honey. And I won't go into the whole convoluted story, but we've connected this again with bees and bees for Bridget, and hence the candles. And harp and candlemas, and so anyhow, and the music we put this to is a Scottish pibroch, called Miel an Bronach, which means a drizzle of honey. So that was appropriate enough. And it connects things together, too, because its form goes between really a two-chord system that is very connected to the Welsh 24 measures. And it all ends up tying together neatly in a package. Okay, so here we go. We are so grateful for this opportunity to be here in Galway. We're so grateful to the Moore Institute and to the many people who have helped us on every corner. And we are particularly very grateful to Lillis O'Leary and Simon. So thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
This is a song from Moore tradition in Donegal. It was popularized, I suppose, by Noin Irian when the Pope came to Ireland. Everyone was singing Shining Hallelujah. You'll hear that at the end, but this is a different version that comes from the little book put out by my namesake, Father Diarmaid O'Leary, or Bardic at the. And the chorus says that there's a special blessing if you look at, if you're contemplating or looking at the Teada, the Virgin, the Virgin's cloak is a special blessing. Virgin Mary Blue, they call it. So I think this is really interesting because the seven joys go back to medieval Spain, Cantigas de Santa Maria, and that it survived in our old traditions, really very interesting. There were pieces for teaching that had the basic tenets of the faith. So the seven joys are the birth, the flight into Egypt, the finding in the temple, the turning of water into wine, although in this case it's beer, because it rhymes better. Sometimes I do say fiend, but it doesn't really work. The raising of the dead, the saving of the world, and the coronation in heaven.
And cattle so are good away than money.
när isnet verkar i mån, så verkar fåsjorna hemma bise, med järsedan äske björ, med järsedan äske björ. En kort så verkar fåsjorna i denna min, när isnet verkar i mor, så verkar fåsjorna hemma bise, med järsen mario björ, med järsen mario björ. Spanien mero, se Spanien helva kor, när sjak såg I den här stugan predo.
Okay, I suppose we're about ready to start. As ready as we'll ever be, maybe, I should say. And I'd like to thank the HHSI, the Historical Harp Society of Ireland, and Siobhan Armstrong for the use of her Gothic gray harp. And as I'm speaking, I realize that I inadvertently left out a couple of pieces in the first set using this harp. And I just realized it now. I'm working without a set list here, and so I apologize for that. But anyhow, it's keeping us company. We'll proceed on, and it's been interesting exploring this Welsh material, and it's very important because the manuscript is a large body of medieval harp music, and it's written in tablature form that helps really define technique and the music. And it really hasn't had enough attention paid to it because it really puts another light on the harmony and music of that time period. But anyhow, this first one, I'll be playing on a Welsh, it's the type of harp that was played in Wales at that period.
Thank you.
harp replaced a harp like this. This is my theory. And it replaces it in microstring. And this type of harp and this straight neck, you'll see in iconography. You can maybe even see it in iconography in Ireland if you want to interpret the stone carving. It seems quite clear that it's in Scotland in the 8th century, harps like this. And this is copied from an early 11th century manuscript, albeit I've doubled the number of strings and increased its size. And about 20 years after that was done, another manuscript was done where 12 women, this is from the Hexateuch, are playing an instrument like this, and they're resting it, balancing it on their feet. They're wearing a dress, and you can see them sitting like this with the harp. And they're sitting, you know, on a little higher chair than I am. So, and it plays very, very well that way. So I see, and the one in Scotland is large size too. So I see nothing wrong with having it large. This first piece of music, would you be able to do the translation?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a very short piece. It's an epitaph, and it's from the Book of Vinurin, which is in a later manuscript, as a lot of you know how, and the language is thought to be 7th century. And this is by the famous Welsh poet Aneurin. And the language is really in Brittonic, an early form of Welsh. And this is a translation. Are you going, is it verbatim from Coke? From
John Coke.
John Coke.
More than 300 of the finest were slain. He struck down at both the middle and the extremities. The most generous man was splendid before the host. From the herd, he used to distribute horses in winter. He used to bring black crows down in front of the wall of the fortified town, though he was not Arthur. Amongst men mighty in feats, in front of the barrier of Alderwood, Gwardur. I want to three hunte casar, if la de ame agedar. Dwyer yn blaen mil clarchar, wedd o le o het mer yn ei ar. Wochore brendyr ar fwr, Cair cyd neu be a'r ffwr. Rong hwf nerthu ynglesur. Ingin dor, wer dor o'r ffwr. Ingin dor, wer dor o'r ffwr.
Something I learned while I was here is that horsehair was used in the making of early barometers. This is a second generation. The first one was made from Welsh timber, and the horsehair was donated from people with Welsh cobs in Wales who sent it to me in the States. In subtle packages, but the horsehair wasn't so subtle. It came straight from the horses, uncleaned, which I wanted because I wanted the oils and all of that. So I had each string was from a different Welsh horse. It was very fun. Mare skin is across the soundboard, and equine bone tuning pins. And you can think if the fellows were on tour up and it would, it's they're pretty lightweight, and if you need the material for a string, you don't have to go far. And it's unique in that these bray pins are over the string, and this is really different technology that no one has been aware of, that early bray pins are over instead of this under fashion. It's pretty cool. It's a whole different thing. And in the manuscript that this is shown with, there's also a lyre. One is bowed and one is blocked, similarly to what Charlie's doing here. And this piece, oh, now I know I'm talking about strings. It's called The Song of the Horses, and it names 24 horses. And it talks about one that's being broken in, and then it names others, and you know, the horses of Taliesin and Arthur, and horses with bad feet, and but it names a 24 horses and all. So it's a very fun piece of music.
Torret an Vinidal, Tithial dan Iscal, Eviolain o Thich Clower, Tan Tan Huden Gwaur, Ich Awel Ichel, Ich Nophob Nivel, Maur I Anivel, Ni Thrig I Gavel, No Maithaur Clear, Clear Fluibir a Tabir, Devar ang Hinebir, Gwaur Gwain Gerthakir. Earth war, earth rees, earth bob, the valleys, earth the valleys, new it on, earth the dire, a bow on, ardu reavi, a bar rees. Adar Ridar, Devon Egas, Lidmigur Kur Fluid, Cruid Earth Fluid, Heed the Night Garant, Die before the Quant, Om Flau Islau, Di Dui Din, Tree Three Nodded, Akar. Arkene, Amar Mayau, Amar Ginethau, Amar Caradau, Cymrwy Teithiau, Amar Wythi, Amar Gwardi, Amar Arthi, Ehobn Roddy Cyr, Amar Taliesin, Amar clay llydfegan, a ffebir llai llwynyn, a grai a'r cynnyn. Hon o'n cynnaelod, awydd, awydd awd, di mor oed enwawd, a'r brwyn brofradawd. Ar fri hon adlaw, nid awt yn tilaw, cef yn barcaidaw, pan afan arnaw, sgwydd rysgarig, orwydd glymenig, warc gyda'r rhywbig, llwyd llw elig, a llanrau llan elwyd, a throi'n y boel gwrannig, a marc the deer men, a mark, kistenin, ag erai clintrin, crag, dir aldwin, penwin, mad divig, kickwagel, o heradig. Bim boop, bim boop, bim siw, bim soup, bim ban, bim ganach, bim gawr, bim fiddach, bim thieve in air, bim call in hair, bim sky, Gavin is gated, Gilloo. Bim Cat, Bim Frither, three friend. Bim Cat, Bim Gavin, our scalprin. Bim Garin, Garland, Gwellin, Gollum. Progress, Milad, Boreal, Codwin, Kennedy, Drew, or Iskid, is our Weddy, Casalwear, Nit be honored, Mike Ambuir.
This is one piece that's in the Welsh Happy manuscript that I actually prefer on the Clarshuck, and maybe it's because it's where I first learned it and worked it out. And I like this piece because it involves only 13 strings. And San Sillan, or St. Giles, was patron saint of cripples, and so when I stumble along, I never feel too badly. And there's cool techniques in here, plethiety, winnenen, plaiting of the bees, tafliety bees, finger throw, thumb choke, tagiety fod. Tonight we have Paul Dooley in the house, who has a wonderful CD interpreting Apu music on the wire strung harp. So I'm not the only one working on this music. Thank you. This next piece, we're really pleased that Lillis is going to lead this one. And he'd best explain the story. I think he...
This is a Arthurian lay. It mentions in the text Rhi Alapa, which could be the King of Britain, certainly at an early stage. And sometimes some of the texts say Rhi Arthur as well. So it's about the king having a dream where he sees this beautiful woman and he would prefer to fall on account of her than to stay chatting with the men where he was. So his knights are Gawain, called Fionn Fallach, in this version, decides to go and find this woman. And he searches the seven seas for 7 weeks and 3 months before he finds the castle on the cliff, and he climbs up and he finds the woman inside playing a harp. And she says, your greeting is very cold, put your head in my lap. And so he does, he falls asleep, and she steals his sword and promptly beheads him. So that's called a sweet song. Scots have a real interesting interpretation of what sweet might mean. So I learned this song from a woman named Katina Garba, who was a fine singer and piper from Vendecula in between North and South Uist. And she learned it from another woman who actually summoned her in about 1960 to teach her this song, because she knew that very few people knew it and she didn't want it to die with her. So much for the spontaneous folk. So here we go.
Zach, do I know?
Getting away with us, from us, and we had meant not to, we'd replaced Coen Cleric with Limerick's Lamentation, thinking, well, it'd be nice to hear something familiar. So I think I'll skip that one too and go right on with, with this one.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is sort of a... This is a long one. It's a long one, and then we added a bit in front of it just to make it better.
Is this your last one?
Yeah. Yeah, that makes it tough on people jumping around in the program. We just found this recently here and thought, oh, wouldn't it be a good idea? This first piece is really a bit of a genealogy on Cathbed, who is the druid who prophesies that the scream from the belly of the pregnant woman was that this child would be a girl and the most beautiful would be female, the most beautiful woman in all of Ireland, and would bring destruction to Ulster. And it goes into, but anyhow, in the genealogy, it goes into who his descendants are, and he's connected to the three sons of Uisnech, who are the three fellows that Deirdre's lamenting in the final lament. So it's kind of cool to put it with it. And Simon introduces the piece on Bronze Age horn.
Shin road three hinyana, doch hath with three, agus doch clan of jagged a hather, eon clan do yarvraher kuri, agus magach mater ked a will a spar. Thank you. Balloo, Tree McAdam and Old Top. Sure Lake Lamai Fowra, a Dutchum Scoosh to ye, Tree McIngin Tawi, Tree Golhahoo.
Oh.
Ah!